Do these mysterious fossils come from outer space, a lost race of giants, or do we still just have no clue about our weird world? Here are a few mysterious fossils science still can't explain. Countless science fiction stories revolve around life on Mars, and more than a few pseudoscientists have found proof of life in odd Martian rock formations and camera glitches. But scientists do take possible life on Mars seriously and actually might have proof in the mysterious meteorite known as ALH84001. The little meteor fell to Earth in 1984, and scientists concluded that it came from Mars and was 4.1 billion years old. Even more shockingly, it has what looked like features of fossilized bacteria in it.
There are multicellular organisms in there.
Yes, I know.
You'd think that claims of alien life would get shut down immediately, but after well over 30 years of study, the Martian meteor is still a mystery. Some groups even claim that it's clear evidence that the moon and other worlds could be littered with fossils knocked away from Earth by asteroid collisions. Could there be dinosaur fossils on Mars? Jurassic Park was cool, but Martian Park would be 10 times cooler. This one's weird. In 2003, a 6-inch long skeleton was discovered in a Chilean ghost town in the Atacama Desert. The tiny mummy provided some serious fuel for alien believers, but in 2018, scientists revealed part of the puzzle. The mummy's DNA confirmed she is very human, and she's even a local. Initially thought to be ancient, scientists eventually determined the remains were only around 40 years old. They also found that her bone structure was as developed as that of a 6-year-old. She had a shocking number of genetic mutations. In all, 54 rare mutations that possibly describe diseases and conditions modern science hasn't seen or can't explain. So she isn't an alien, but it might actually be less weird if she were.
Put the phone down.
When a research team discovered the fossils of a small hominid in 2003, it forced researchers to rethink the human chain of evolution, as well as modern humans' place in it. Dubbed Homo floresiensis, the hominid was diminutive, with samples averaging only a little over 3 feet tall, with big feet. Researchers began calling them hobbits, for obvious reasons. So far, the fossils have only been found on one island in Indonesia, and records indicate that they lived a mere 50,000 years ago. If that's true, it would mean Homo sapiens weren't the only hominid species walking the planet back in ancient times. Others believe the hobbits were actually Homo sapiens who settled on Indonesia and, over centuries, developed dwarfism. Oddly, it seems like the second option has captured more steam among researchers. Though if anybody digs up a shiny gold ring and calls it their precious, all bets are off. Since the discovery of early hominid fossils, many researchers focused on small geographic areas where they felt certain they'd find fossils of our ancestors. All that changed in 2015 when researchers in South Africa found hominid fossils that didn't relate to any of the known hominid fossil families. Named Homo naledi, the fossils were from a new family of human predecessors. Homo naledi fossils occupy a weird place in the human family tree, falling between hominids and apes. Oddly, the specimen was less than 350,000 years old, meaning it lived right before Homo sapiens appeared. Homo naledi was so out of place, it would be like finding out that Neanderthals were still alive somewhere in our world today.
How do you think me live this long? And me so smart from knowledge? A good diet?
How Homo naledi developed at all, and whether our ancestors actually interacted with them, is still a mystery. When we imagine dinosaurs, we usually picture them in warm tropical climates, but recently, scientists have discovered a new species of dinosaur in the most unlikely of places, Arctic Alaska. Since these giant lizards lived in polar climates, they must have created their own heat, totally changing the idea that dinosaurs were only cold-blooded creatures. Most likely, their blood systems were much more diverse than originally thought. But the biggest mystery is how these frigid dinosaurs made it up there in the first place, so far removed from the biggest populations of their scaly cousins. Something had to get them up there, and scientists are hard-pressed to figure out what made them migrate north. Discovered in 1955 by collector Francis Tully, the first Tully monster fossil completely defied explanation. Nobody could figure out what the monster was actually related to. Looking at reproductions of the monster show why it was so confusing. The main part of the creature had a body like a cuttlefish, with vertical fins sticking off the top. Eyepods stuck out from the sides of the body. Most unusually, the monster had a long proboscis with a bunch of teeth on the end. One bit of clarity came when some samples appeared to show a rudimentary spinal cord, letting researchers know that they could at least classify it as an early vertebrate. Aside from that, the Tully monster still remains a baffling evolutionary turn in our planet's history. The Paiutes in Nevada tell stories of a race of red-haired giants that lived in Nevada for thousands of years before they settled the land. According to the Paiute, the tribes unified to defeat the giants and finally kicked them out of their homeland after a protracted war. Settlers to the west didn't originally believe the stories. That changed in 1911 when miners discovered Lovelock Cave, which contained hundreds of ancient artifacts, along with huge bones that looked human. But they had to come from people nearly 10 feet tall, although they might have just been bear bones. Digging also revealed fossilized handprints that were much bigger than any human handprint. The most interesting find, however, was the skulls. Each skull found had an oddly shaped jawbone and elongated features. The skulls are now held at a nearby museum. Everyone knows that dinosaurs died out from a giant asteroid collision, but few people know that the dinosaur extinction was not the only mass extinction that our planet faced. There have been five, the worst one being the end-Permian event, which happened 252 million years ago. The biodiversity loss was catastrophic, and it took millions of years for animal life to get back to pre-extinction levels.
Finally!
But here's the weirdest part. Nobody knows why that particular extinction event happened. For years, scientists have struggled to find out why so many species died seemingly out of nowhere. Geologists have discovered microscopic fractures in quartz crystals that date from the time of the extinction, implying that some sort of massive force shook the Earth. It could have been an asteroid collision, just as with the dinosaurs. An even more exotic theory held by many scientists is that the coal in Canada and basalt in Siberia might have blown up out of nowhere, causing a huge ash cloud and making almost all life on Earth go extinct. Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more messed up history videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.